The House Ethics Committee investigating Congressman Matt Gaetz has reached out to the women whom the congressman allegedly had sexual relations with, including someone as young as 17 years old, according to a source familiar with the committee's work. Oh yeah, that DOJ investigation, which came to an end, apparently the investigation hasn't really come to an end when it comes to this House Ethics Committee looking into the allegations. Now, just rewinding a little bit, a few years ago, news broke regarding a DOJ investigation that was launched under the Trump administration, by the way. This investigation didn't start under the Biden administration. And it was over allegations that Matt Gaetz had sexual relations with a minor and that he had basically paid the minor to travel to his state, to where he was, in order to engage in a sexual relationship. That was the allegation. Well, apparently this House Ethics Committee was not satisfied with the DOJ investigation. They kept investigating and they talked to more women. They reached out to more people. And so now there's a sign that the GOP-led committee's investigation into this Florida Republican, Matt Gaetz, has recently expanded to include questioning around allegations of sex crimes. According to CNN, sources say the committee has also reached out to the Justice Department requesting materials from its investigation into Gaetz, which included allegations of lobbying violations, sex trafficking, and possible obstruction of justice. Again, now that federal probe, which included these allegations, concluded back in 2023. So last year they wrapped it up, and apparently Matt Gaetz is innocent. That's according to the DOJ. But there must be something going on with what the House Ethics Committee has been looking into. There must have been some incriminating evidence that they've come across based on the conversations that they've had with other women. And now they're requesting that the DOJ provide some of the investigative materials that they had come across as they were doing their investigation. Now, Gaetz has repeatedly denied any wrongdoing, including ever having sex with a minor or paying for sex. He says that those allegations were not true, have never been true, and the people who spread those lies have been exposed, indicted, and imprisoned. Have they? Have they? But he also thinks that this House Ethics Committee investigation, which again, these are Republicans. Like, there are Republicans investigating him, members of his own party. He argues that this is just retaliation for his decision to oust former House Speaker and former Republican Congressman Kevin McCarthy. So I don't know what the truth is, right? This story just broke. I thought that after the DOJ dropped the investigation into Matt Gaetz, they would let it go and that was it. But no, there's apparently more going on, and I'm uncertain of what the committee has found. I'm uncertain if it's anything really robust enough to go after Matt Gaetz aggressively, but the fact that they've reached out to the DOJ, I think, should be concerning for Gaetz. Now, McCarthy denies that the investigation into Matt Gaetz was motivated by Gaetz ousting McCarthy as House Speaker. He says, I don't believe them to be conservatives, McCarthy said in November, referring to the eight Republicans who actually voted to oust him. Gaetz was one of them. McCarthy had said at the time that it's driven by Gaetz, and it was all based upon ethics complaints that happened in the last Congress. He would throw his country away to try to protect himself for what would come out as the truth. That is what Kevin McCarthy had said. What does Kevin McCarthy know? And what does the Ethics Committee know? The Justice Department, by the way, does not have to comply with a voluntary request from the House Ethics Committee. And that's according to Norman Eisen, who served as counsel to House Democrats in former President Donald Trump's first impeachment. If a request seems merited as part of the usual accommodation process between the legislative and executive branches, DOJ will sometimes provide some information, but they tend to be withholding of sensitive investigative materials. And even when the House issues a subpoena, the Justice Department typically holds back much of their internal investigation. I don't know why they do that. If there's any evidence of wrongdoing that the House Ethics Committee came across, the DOJ should cooperate and provide some of the materials that the Ethics Committee is asking for. Again, we're talking about Republicans investigating one of their own. That never happens, okay? That never happens. And I'm super curious to figure out what is happening here and how this story is gonna continue developing. Now, as part of the sprawling investigation, Joel Greenberg, a former Florida tax collector and close confidant of Matt Gaetz, pleaded guilty in 2021 to 6 federal charges, including soliciting and paying a minor in the Gaetz allegation for sex. The Ethics Committee, controlled by Democrats, originally, by the way, opened its investigation in 2021. So this is the previous congressional session where Democrats still had control of the House. They launched the investigation, publicly announcing that it was examining a range of allegations, including that Gaetz violated sex trafficking laws. But the committee later deferred the investigation at the request of the Justice Department, which again eventually dropped the investigation entirely. But it appears that the House Ethics Committee, now under Republican control, decided to continue with the investigation. And so a source familiar with the House panel's work previously told CNN that the Justice Department's decision not to bring charges against Gaetz does not impact what the committee will and won't investigate. The committee plans to examine the same allegations they were looking into when they opened the investigation in 2021, the source told CNN. So buckle up. I feel like this is a story that will continue to develop. And once it does, once we have new details, we will share them with you. It might be the case that Gaetz is found completely innocent. He denies it. The DOJ didn't, find any evidence that led to the prosecution of Matt Gaetz. So we're gonna have to wait and see. But this doesn't look good. I just have that gut feeling that this is not good news for Matt Gaetz.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.